I grab Edgar on the shoulder, you know, helping him up because we both fell, and I go, "Is that the fucking pig thing you've been telling me about?"
On the other side.
Is that the fucking what?
I'm staying on the other side. I was just helping you up. I was. I'm hanging back for a minute.
A little disoriented.
I thought he came over with me.
Yeah, what happens when you see little Tweety birds when you fall off a fucking wall.
Okay, I grab Daigle by the shoulder and go, "Is that the fucking pig man Edgar's always talking about?"
That's either the fucking boar or Lokar's in there getting his cheese claps. Either way, we gotta move fast. We gotta move with haste.
I put my spike knuckles on, and then I move slowly while listening and keeping open ears.
I'm trying to listen and see
what's going on.
I try to close in silently. I sneak.
You guys going towards the house?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I was just thinking something that'd be hella funny. It's like everybody's being quiet, and then all you hear is "fucking kill," and I throw an oil fire at the building.
You could.
I'm not doing that. Sidebarring.
We don't know how many there are.
When I come over, since no one asked, when I come over the fence, do I see any other buildings in the surrounding?
You see just the one building up ahead. Okay. Now that you guys are over the fence and it's unobscured by the trees, you can see there are actually two torches standing in front of the house.
Okay, I'm sneaking up I'm sneaking up and I'm trying to gesture to Daigle to follow me going to the darker side of the cabin, looking for possibly an open window to look through or something like that.
A second.
Okay, so you guys are going to start heading in. Wilton, what are you doing?
We're facing the front door, I'm assuming, yeah?
Yeah, so let me describe how far back it is. It's probably set just about 100... It's like half a block away is, like, how far the house is from you guys. It's like 100 feet or so. And, you guys can see that there's, like, a small smattering of trees just around in this area. And then over by the torches is the house. And you can't really see too much of the ground. There's a lot of plants still growing in this area, too.
Let's see what I want to do.
Yeah, you see, Daigle you guys coming and John in from are heading towards.
We're going around the side to a more dark side of the cabin, trying to look for an open window where we can spy.
I'm gonna hang where I'm at and just have my bow ready, pointed at the front door. I'm not gonna pull it, but you know, just waiting if someone comes out. You know,
do stealth check.
Ooh.
Or, all three of you do stealth checks. You guys are trying to move stealthily around the side of the house, and you're trying to also, Wilton, right? Move stealthily, or?
Well, I'm just staying where I'm at, wherever I'm... Yeah. Is there a tree or something?
Oh, I got a plus three in roll stealth. Anyway,
but I got a plus two in survival or perception, if that helps or anything.
I have a survival bonus, but no stealth and no dex bonus.
That is okay. Yeah, so you guys... Okay, sweet. So you guys head around the side of the house. Oh yeah, Daigle, are you holding a torch?
Oh no, none of us. I think
I don't have a torch.
Daigle, you were holding a torch
earlier. Yeah, I don't think I have it anymore. But Edgar has a torch, and I'm just plus. I got a plus three in stealth though, but he's not with us. He's on the other side of the fence. I don't know if you're still holding the torch.
What would you do with your torch, Matthew, or Daigle?
I feel like I dropped it like back then when I was running. Sorry.
You guys see an enormous uproar of fire, flaming inferno rushing towards you from the south. No, I'm just kidding. But Matt, keep track of your torch. That's why, though. That's why.
Why did this happen?
Because, Nate, goddamn, we stick to theme, don't we?
Yeah.
Then we get burning shit again.
We're bad guys.
That'd be good, actually. Okay, highs or lows, Matt? Highs or lows, Matt? You misplaced your torch. High or low?
All right.
Oh yeah!
Oh God!
Hi. Huh?
Hi.
Oh, that would be low. You dropped it in the forest behind you, and
Was there?
Why
fire
are the cause of all fires?
He didn't say there was one yet. He just said okay.
So you moving through the dark, it is definitely hard to be stealthy, and both of you are like cracking twigs as you're moving through the wood.
Stealthy as fuck.
And John's standing back. He's got his bow cocked. Edgar's on the other side of the fence. Like, you guys are fucking...
Well,
I don't know what
you're saying. It's Wilton that has his bow cocked. I'm sneaking with Daigle.
Wilton, that's what I meant. Sorry.
Yeah.
The only thing that John has cocked is Daigle's dick.
Definitely caught.
So it's locked. Okay, as you guys are sneaking around the side of the house, and Edgar, I guess you can see this too. You can see the figure of the boy wander in front of the torches, and you see him grab a big length of rope that appears to be tied to the ground to a metal ring, and you see he just hucks the whole pile of rope in at the ground, and it just like falls through the ground. That's what you guys see as you're sneaking around the side of the house, and then the boy opens the door and slams it shut behind him, into the little cabin.
So he threw a rope down a hole, like is it the rope tied off onto something? Like
yeah, it's tied to a metal ring in between the two torches.
All right, and then did he use that rope to go down into where he went to?
It's hard to tell where the hole is because it's all like, you know, you can't really see it because it's like behind like bushes and shit. But what you guys saw is like he lifted up this rope and he threw it at the ground and it just all disappears.
But he didn't go down it.
He did not go down it. No, he didn't. He dropped the rope and then he went inside the house and shut the door behind him.
Oh, I thought he went in like some cellar doors. That's my mistake. Nope. Okay. That's
and you guys can hear... You guys can hear the pounding of a hammer from inside the house. Just sounds like he's like pounding something behind the door. There's like something being beaten. And as you guys get closer to the cabin, as you're sneaking around the side of it, you hear the sounds of the getting louder. And you see a hand emerge from a hole underneath one of the torches where the rope had fallen in. You see the rope pull taut. You see one hand appear at the ridge of the hole, then another, and then a pig head raise above the hole as a huge pig-headed man, naked, completely naked, pushes himself up and out of the hole. And you hear him, and he turns around. And he's like looking right over at John and Daigle, and he just starts bolting right towards you. And everybody roll for initiative.
Look at that fucking hog.
Including me.
Can I talk about the one on his head?
Yes, everybody. Okay. It's Wilton's turn. So Wilton, from where you're standing, like you're near the entrance. So imagine like you're looking forwards at the cabin. Your friends are around the left side of the cabin because they've like hiked off that way. And you see this happen. You see the rope go down. You see the pounding inside the house after the kid runs in the door. And you see a huge fucking pig-headed figure just pull itself out of a hole, bathed in the torchlight, seems to sniff the air and goes, just makes a beeline running straight towards your friends.
I shoot.
Edgar sees this too. But yeah.
At his head.
Okay.
Roll
an attack, and this guy's well.
Motherfucker, man! Every goddamn time I try to do some shit, what the fuck, man?
You usually do pretty good. This just happened twice today, but let's
see. We got our days, honestly.
Okay, high or low?
We'll go low.
This is how we roll these. Oh, it's 100.
Oh, what the fuck?
Oh shit! So. Your bowstring snaps off your bow.
Lovely.
Fuck. God damn.
It's gonna take it's not broken, but it's gonna take a little effort to get it back on.
Can I still move?
Yes.
I hop over the wall with Edgar. Edgar.
Oh, do it.
I'm down a weapon.
There's a pig guy over there.
You saw your bird.
Rolodex.
You still have your bird. Your bird can distract people, can't it?
My bird can just fly up and cacata me when there's people around. That's all it does for me right now.
And I feel like he's explained this several times that all this bird does is alert.
A 6+3.
I think your bird has two tricks. I don't know what your other one is.
That my other one's just to send messages to people.
It's so like, oh, yeah. You can tell Daigle he's fucked. If you want, you know, send him a line, just kidding. Oh, but it's
like, dude, trick is that it licks bird feet off of him.
So, yeah, you hop back over the fence. You fall down on the other side at Edgar's feet, and you're just laying there on the other side of the bone fence next to a big, like probably an ox's femur.
Edgar, the pig people are here.
The what? I don't know if you saw that.
The pig people are in trouble. My butt is snapped.
It is Daigle's turn.
Oh, shit. I see this log coming Digger. Towards me.
Yeah, he's running right at you. Well, running right at... It actually appears to be running right at John, but...
Okay, how far away is... How much feet is he away about right now, probably? Will he catch us in the next turn or this turn after
he'll
my turn?
He'll catch you in the next turn. Or he'll catch you in this first turn. After when it's his turn, he can be upon you.
Okay, can I throw a knife at his ankle?
Yes.
All right. Essentially try to hamstring him a little bit.
Watch out, he's naked, he's slippery.
I have one inspiration. Can I use my inspiration?
Yes. Do it now. Good idea.
Fuck.
By the way, I liked how you said hamstring when it's a pig.
Oh, ham in this bitch.
So I don't think there's anything with my.
That's a 10.
A 5 with the. I don't think I can save it. Well,
5 plus 5.
Oh yeah, because I have the test boot.
That's gonna barely miss. It sticks in the ground right in front of him.
Shit. Do I have any other action after that?
You can move.
We're in the open, right? We're not in bushes.
You are kind of, I would say that you guys are partially obscured by the scrubs and whatnot. And then about 20 feet to your left is the bone fence that wraps around this whole property.
So I can move 30 feet in a booking turn, right? So shit. I have no way to know whose action is next, right? I can't tell if it's John's action next or his action next, right?
Oh, it's fine, dude. It's John's next.
Oh, John's next?
Well, you would assume because John's next.
Okay, so I hop over the... Then I can run back and hop over the fence then, I guess?
Sure. Yeah, go ahead and do a dexterity. All right, yeah, so... He throws a knife... You describe it, Matt. You'll describe it funnier.
I check the knife... Yes, I fucking hit him. Come, you son of a... He's not slowing down. You fucking hit him. No hoof there. Fuck. Run, John, run. Fuck. It's a fucking bull race. I grab the fence. I throw myself over. I roll. Fuck. Don't taste like shit. Fuck. This fucking Commodore. What the fuck is going on? Fuck.
You see Daigle throws a knife and goes flying over the fence. And then he just throws himself over the fence. John's third.
Run, John, run!
Oh, you guys fucking left me! The fuck! And I'm looking at where Daigle fucking went, and I'm just like, fuck! And so I go to jump over. I do exactly what Daigle did, except I don't throw a knife. I just fucking book it.
This is the fucking worst rodeo I've ever been to in my whole fucking life!
Yep, so you can get to the fence line and go ahead and roll something to get over it. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
We're going to tell if you fell on this side of the fence or the other side of the fence, high or low.
Let's go high.
You fall on the other side of the fence. You trip over the fence.
Oh, my God!
You throw yourself at the fence. You get caught on it, and it feels like you're falling backwards, and then all of a sudden you go right over the side. You land next to Daigle on the ground.
Fuck my shoulder! Why did you guys
fucking hurt?
What the fuck, man?
Fuck your shoulder! My heart's racing! It's one of the fastest fucking pig man!
Oh, sure! Just fucking leave. The guy only has goddamn brass knuckles. Mr. Bowman jumps over. Mr. Knife Man jumps over. You fucking left me there, you fucks!
Edgar's turn.
All right, I'm gonna go ahead and attempt the fuck. So how big is this wall? At the top of it? Is it? No, I mean, I mean, at the top of it, is it like thin? Is it thick? Is it thick enough to stand on top
of it? It's probably about 6 inches wide. It's not very wide because it's just bones and vines.
Yeah.
Okay. Fuck.
It's an average size.
There's skulls there too, so the skulls are the widest thing, really.
So, well, I guess essentially it's only 5 feet tall. You can kind of like jump and chuck something, right?
Well, you might be able to. Yeah,
you probably just
look
over the fence.
You probably lunge.
Yeah, you can hook it over. Yeah. Okay. Well,
you just have to move a bit closer.
Okay, well, I'm going to do that and go ahead and repeat what I did to the other guy with another Molotov because I don't have much shit left. So I'm going to rip some more of my shit off.
That's you,
light it up, and we're gonna fucking chuck it at this big bitch.
Okay, so you guys laying on the ground, you hear the footsteps running towards you, and Edgar appears about like 20 feet from you guys, and you can see the fucking thing running right towards you guys in the fence, like running in your direction now. And yeah, you have your Molotov cocktail in your hand. Roll a d20.
Fuck.
Oh fuck. That's gonna hit.
And then I'm just, yeah, I fucking twirl that shit. It's like, I thought I smelled fucking bacon. And I fucking
roll. Nice. Roll 2d4 damage. And then that's gonna be plus your intelligence.
My intelligence is plus 3.
Okay.
So,
11 damage.
Shit. 11, yeah. My man.
That was my last fucking oil vial, you guys. So there's no more fires after this.
Well, I mean, if you can collect this fucking collect that bacon.
This thing is like, it's on fire. And unlike the other man who, as soon as he was set on fire, was running away, this guy is just now running at you as like a burning Hulk. And he runs up to the bone gate, doesn't try to go over it or anything. He runs straight through the bone fence. Bones go flying over Daigle and John's heads as they're there. Daigle's not on the ground. He's just like kind of crouching. He landed on his feet. You got a good roll. But John is on the ground, and the creature is looming over you, and it swings a fist down at you, John.
Fuck.
I guess I try to dodge it.
I bet you do.
Yeah.
All right, and that's gonna hit.
Okay.
Oh fuck!
How much damage?
We have armor now, fellas.
It's gonna do 6 points of damage.
Oh, that would have killed me. Oh god.
Can I retaliate with a counter?
No.
Okay.
You don't have one of those yet. Sorry. All right, and the creature's just looming over you, and you can hear it sniffing inside of its hood. It starts like grabbing for your bag. It punches you in the face, and then it's grabbing your bag.
Desmodivines.
It's Wilton's turn.
Can I run over there and pocket sand that motherfucker?
They don't have eyes, right?
They do.
But I can plug his nose up. You know, he's going to be real sneezing when there's some dirt in his fucking face.
You guys don't remember, do you?
The dissection.
Nobody remembers. Yeah, the dissection.
No.
It doesn't have eyes. I stuck my hands in its eye socket.
No, I'm not worried about its eyes. I said I could throw dirt in its snout.
Sure, you run over.
Yeah.
It doesn't have an actual... You guys...
It smelt us. Fucking do it.
Is that what you do, Wilton? John's bag. Is that what you do, Wilton?
Yeah, I'm gonna do that.
Okay, yeah, so you run over there, go ahead and roll a d20. It's just gonna be a dexterity attack.
Oh my god.
It's a helmet.
You go to grab your pocket sand and you pull your whole pocket out and it just goes inside out and the pocket sand falls all over the ground.
Damn it.
Oh shit.
This is a statistical anomaly.
So Daigle
could cut its fucking tendons and
bullshit. Fucking like 5-1s. I better get some XP for all these critical fails.
This is a third one. Oh yeah, you have 3. Add 3 XP. Or wait, how much XP? No, 15 XP.
Hey, do I get XP for that critical 20 that I did earlier?
Yes, you do. 5 XP.
Oh, and
baby.
I get XP for my 1. I rolled.
You
rolled
do too. Yep, 5 XP. Good thing somebody brought that up. Thank you very much. Oh yeah, every listeners at home, we do have a home rule now. If you get a critical fail or a critical roll, you get 5 XP right off the top. You learn from your successes, you learn from your failures.
Nobody remembers though that these pig helmets, they're boar heads they're wearing over their heads, and they have no eyes, and they're just The last thing we knew is that an arrow went through one's ear and it was dead.
Daigle's
or the
turn.
Wound was at its ear.
What? I had to go to the wounded on its ear. I run up there. I take my knife and I fucking try to grab it, swing one arm around it, hold it tight, and jab my knife right into its ear.
Okay. Yeah, roll an attack.
10 plus 5. So I have a, I got a plus, was it plus two to dex and then whatever my knife bonus is, right?
We have it all, we had it all tallied up together, boy. We had it in one bonus.
Yeah. So like, yeah.
It's one plus your proficiency plus your dex modifier, which is five total. I already know this. It's 15 and you hit. You should know this too, buddy. Now roll
I'm slowly adding it all together.
Sorry. That's okay. So seven damage altogether?
Yes. In the ear. Come here, fucking banking son of a bitch. Don't you touch my friend.
All right. You stab right through the pig's head and you can tell that it like, you know, stabbed into the real head beneath it. You hear like a squeal from inside of there and you see some blood leak out from the bottom of the mask.
I bet you heard that coming, don't you, you son of a bitch?
John's turn.
Okay, so seeing what just happened, I throw a hammer fist at the knife that's in its head.
Okay.
As hard as I can, and then follow up with
my fingers.
And then follow up with a right hook.
All right, that's roll a d20 and then another d20.
That's hella dope.
All right, so the first one is like, what, 10 plus... Is your attack bonus 5 or what is it?
Yeah, it's plus 5 to hand to hand.
Okay, sweet. So the first punch that hits the knife hits successfully. And you normally roll a d4 for damage. Go ahead and roll 2d4 for this one.
So the one he hammered in hit?
Yeah, the one he hammered in hit.
That's badass.
For 7. Oof. So yeah, you come in with the left hook and you slam that blade and it just pushes the hilt of the knife deep into the mask, you know, and the blade goes even further. There's more shrieking, another gush of blood from beneath the mask. Daigle's fingers are a little squished together, but he's still got a grip of the blade. And your other hook comes around the other side of the mask as just like a punch. And you can tell that you just basically hit the boar skull. It just didn't glanced get through. It. Yeah.
Okay.
It is Edgar's turn. Oh, the thing is burning too. Oh, during this turn, so he's on fire during your turn, Edgar. So he takes another 3 points of damage.
Fuck. Oh, dude.
Dude, this guy has a lot of fucking health.
Wilton has. Oh, but your bow's fucked up because you had that other oil arrow. I don't know if that's gonna combust if you hit him. It's not gonna matter. He's already on fire. Fuck, I don't really know.
Don't you have throwing knives?
No, I have a single knife and I have no knife attack plus. Like, the knife attack is just going to be a very basic attack. My thing is chucking vials at people.
Yeah, that's you're also you're proficient with thrown weapons.
I do. I have a bottle of brandy.
You can throw a knife.
I didn't know because like my only attack thing just says throw acid plus 5.
Gotcha. Yeah, if you throw a knife,
1d4 plus 1 damage.
Throw a knife, you're just going to lose the intelligence bonus. Yeah, so the bonus you're going to get, you're just going to get your proficiency and you're going to get your proficiency plus 1 and then dex.
Fuck, man. I'm trying to think where you hit in the fucking leg to try to leave him immobile. I don't know where the fuck you would
hamstring.
That would be on the ankle. Back of the ankle.
The ankle or back of the knee. Any place where there's a tendon.
Achilles.
I'm gonna go ahead and try to throw my knife then at
that's what I tried.
Okay. You throw your knife at the burning Hulk.
I don't want to waste my fucking thing. 14 that's
plus 1. 15. That's gonna hit.
Hell yeah. So it can't fucking hurt any.
Yep, and you get a d4 plus 1. So roll plus 1 but also minus 1. So yeah, just roll a d4. It sticks into his leg, but because he's just like standing there right now, it's hard to tell if it has, you know, done what you want it to do yet.
Okay. Well, I forgot.
He's standing over me, not kneeling?
No.
No, what? He's not standing. He's not kneeling over me?
Oh, he was leaning down over you.
Okay.
He's probably standing up.
I thought he was straddling my character.
No, he was going through your bag like a wild bear. He might be.
So the thing. so go ahead and roll a strength check, John.
Calm the fuck okay. on.
So the creature rips the bag right off of your body and rips the strap of your satchel. And it tears open the whole bag. All the contents fall out onto the ground. And it grabs the cloth wrap dismodifines and it just shoves them cloth and all. Like it lifts up its mask and just shoves them into its mouth and starts chewing them. Black goo is like dripping around the corners of its mouth. And the mask just falls off the back of its head to the ground. And you can see the creature's like the black shadows of like where its eyes once were. And you can see the scars all over its face. And the scars are slightly like glowing in the moonlight with the silver inlaid within them. And you see him just like, he like flexes really tight. The knife pops out of his leg and lands on the ground with him flexing. And you can see his veins just like turning black.
Can I move her? Is it my turn next?
All three dismodifines, even though they were all individually wrapped.
He just shoved all of them into his mouth.
So I'm just seeing this motherfucker about to Hulk out.
Oh yeah.
Ah shit.
Do I be heroic? You see him currently hulking out. You see all that shit I just said.
Can I take my combat dagger and stab him where his eyes are supposed to be?
Sure. Go for it.
No, please come on, roll good. Let's go.
You're like
after okay. So what you guys are hearing right now is a nat 20, right? And so Wilton, after like three terrible successes, talk about learn from your mistakes, like rolls a fucking nat 20, jams his eye right into this flaming fucking black veined screeching Hulk's head, and go ahead and roll 2d4 damage.
My are you counting that knife bonus I have? I have a +3 to knife attack.
What about that dice boner you just
got? It says 1d4 +3.
Yeah, yeah, because that's your dexterity attack. Modifier. So that's okay. Gonna be 6.
Oh, okay, altogether. Okay.
Gotcha. Okay, sweet. Yeah. So it's bleeding out of its like its scarred eye hole there. And your dagger's just like sunk all the way to the hilt. You can see the thing like kind of wavering. And it's like getting its hands together and like just like it's about to like reach towards you. It's Daigle's turn.
Oh, do I have advantage because of its position?
Oh shit, Wilton just had.
I'm gonna try to take my other knife and I'm gonna try to slit its throat.
You would be able to do a sneak attack.
Okay, can I do a sneak attack towards its throat?
Absolutely.
So that way, okay.
I think we're doing like a weird zombie thing, so I don't know.
18 altogether. Yeah, it's gonna hit. So roll a 3d4, I believe it is, your sneak attack damage, plus all your right. dexterity modifier. Boom, boom. 11
with the dexterity, +2.
Black blood sinks from its neck, stinking of like. Ripe, rotten carcass and just drops down his whole body, like putting out the fire of its like burning chest, this black blood leaking down it. And the creature falls to its knees and then lands right on top of John on the ground, leaking its blood right into his face.
That's how you fucking do it. Why the fuck would you go for your eye socket? This fucking creature's consuming it. Stop soaking, stop consuming it. You caught it on his fucking neck like a goddamn fucking chicken. Bullcrag, your ignorance seems to amaze me every fucking time. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Hey, Wilton had a good idea. Wilton tried to get the sand into his nose.
That yes, just blind a creature that doesn't see. That's a great fucking strategy, isn't it?
Yeah, it's open
round. I go up.
Fuck! I push the motherfucker off me. I pull my cleaver out, pissed off, grab the fucking head by anything I can grab it by, and try to hack it off.
Yeah, so there's a knife in his head, so you can rip Wilton's knife out of his head and.
I cut the head off,
and then I throw it to the side and I stick my arm down its fucking throat hole and try to grab my desmodivines.
Roll a, what is this called? We're gonna do an insanity. We're gonna do an insanity save. So go ahead and roll a wisdom check.
I apologize, Casey.
My wisdom is plus two.
I didn't realize what you were trying to do.
You gain an insanity point. How many do you have now?
Oh, about the sand.
Yeah, the sand in the nose. That was actually hella clever.
I have two.
Okay.
My bad. Sorry.
Do I grab my any remnants of those modifines? I mean, he ate them in the cloth, so.
You pull out three chewed up scraps of cloth with the Desmodivine in them. And there's still the Desmodivine inside of one. It's just chewed up.
But I put it in my pack.
Okay.
But it's finest.
Okay. So as you pull your hand out with this like scrap of the Desmodivine, you begin shaking. And like you look at the head in your hands and you drop it and you realize you have a deep fear of these disgusting creatures. This whole thing that happened was like a traumatic experience for you. So you're now like shaking on the ground, holding your container of Desmodivine and horrifically afraid of this monster that you guys just faced.
Can I walk up to John? Is this open right now?
Mm-hmm.
I grab him by the shirt and I smack him in the face. Like, get a hold of yourself, motherfucker. Listen to me. Here's some canvas. Here's a rope. Go collect your shit and let's get the fuck out of here. We got to go find our boy, man. Lokar's missing. We still haven't found this motherfucker.
So go ahead and write this down, John. You have a pigman phobia.
That's the opposite of what I got.
Man, now he's going to be afraid of Joseph.
Fuck you. That was a fat joke, wasn't it? I'm going to strangle you.
Anyways, yeah, I want to collect my belongings the best I can and whatever I can.
Yeah, I mean, you can grab every. You tell me how you're gonna carry it. You know, it's
well,
your,
Casey.
Your bag
what? Wilton, what did you? Wilton, what did you offer?
I have a 10x10 canvas, and then I have what's it called? I have 60 foot of rope, but I have 30 foot, like 2 30-foot ropes.
I bundle it up in that shit.
Okay, yeah, so you take a small length of rope and, use a survival check real quick.
Plus four.
Right. Nice.
Excellent, dude. So quickly, you make a quick little sling, basically, which is just like a satchel. It's just got like two knots holding the corners of the canvas, and then you can put it over your shoulder, the bit of rope, and inside of it has all the contents of your bag now.
Okay, well, feeling pumped up and slightly
all right,
insane.
I take that out of my...
I walk into that. Before, okay. I jump the fence and try to walk into that cabin and grab that motherfucker inside.
Okay.
If I can.
So Casey, just reduce one of your. So now you have a 30-foot rope and you have a 25-foot rope.
Yeah, that's what I did.
Okay, cool.
Can I tell Edgar?
Oh, he didn't take the whole the 30. Okay, gotcha.
No, it wouldn't take 30 feet of rope to do that. So you go up to the house and you try to get in.
Yeah.
Okay, you're going up to the house and you walk up to those torches, you can see that there's actually like two holes in the ground. You can see that there's a big metal ring on the ground where the rope has gone into the hole on the right, and the hole on the left. As you walk back, you see a small man. You see a man shivering down in the bottom of the hole, and he looks up and he says, "Yo, John, is that really you, man?"
Again, Lokar. Tell me that's not you down there.
Rope, huh?
He says it's me, man. Come on, throw me the rope, man. It sucks down here, dude. It's
I'm gonna
really
get
cold.
You out. I just need to settle something real quick.
Can I run over there? Can I run over there? Real
yes.
Fast. Dude, what the fuck you doing? Look at me, a fucking pigman. Hoist yourself. Hoist your fucking self.
He says,
I don't know what kind of
like
fucking
not...
demonic rituals.
He says there's not.
No,
Gary,
shut
like,
the
grips.
Fuck up. We're trying to figure things out. He could be some kind of fucking pig. We release this man. He might be a pig man. You don't know. Fuck. Jack, fuck.
Is the
what
other guy still
right
in there?
We don't know
Lokar,
anything that's happening
the
right
other
now.
Guy?
I'm breaking in
rope.
Right now.
John.
Oh, we're not inside. Oh, no, you're already inside.
Need light.
No, I'm trying to break in. I don't know if I'm in.
Okay, one thing at a time. I don't know if I am I supposed to respond to you, Matt? I don't know. I don't know all of what you're saying.
So
he's yelling at Lokar. I'm trying to break in, and the Casey is also trying to break in. That's what's going on.
I'm talking to John right now with Lokar in earshot. John, he could be a part of the same ritual that turned that man into a fucking pig man.
Yeah, which is exactly why I want to get a hold of him.
Lokar yells up. He's like, I don't want to be a pig man. I just want to go cook alligators again. I'm done with all this adventure and shit.
I look down and say, you're going to be a fucking cook. No pigmans are coming in.
You're a cook, Lokar. We'll see you.
Just a minute. One thing at a time.
Yeah, I'm still trying to break in. I'm just yelling over my shoulder.
Okay, now you guys both roll strength, you and Wilton, because you guys are breaking in together.
And that I got a plus zero.
You can tell that the door has been reinforced. There are no windows. It appears that there's just one entrance, the doorway. You guys are trying to get through the door, but it's going to take some time.
Well, I have a crowbar. Can I just use that to bust it open?
You can use the crowbar. Yeah, go ahead and roll a roll 2d20. You got advantage to busting the door open. But it's a strength roll. No, just you, because you have the
crowbar. Okay.
Only one person can use a crowbar. Okay, next.
Beautiful.
That's another 5 XP for the boy.
For the boy. Do it for the boy.
Nice.
Okay, so you are going to break the door open, but we're going to take a slight delay as they're talking before you crack the door open because you guys got the low first roll. So it's going to take some time before, you know, you get the crowbar to pop right through it.
I'd say once it pops, I just burst in.
Okay. Edgar.
I'd like to investigate the body to see if there's anything like new that I can figure out that we didn't already see with the body we recovered.
Oh, so you're alone over there at the broken fence.
I'm still over there with that. I just want to observe the body if there's anything on it or something about it that's worth noting.
Okay. Yeah. Roll a d20 investigation. And you know what? Since you've dissected one of the, it's okay. Since you've dissected one of these creatures, go ahead and roll it with advantage. I was just about to say.
Second. Go.
Oh, second.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Okay, this is bizarre.
You get
5 XP, and you look over the body, you look over the head. You notice, because the head has been cut off, there is a bit of the spine sticking out, and you can see that there is actually something like inscribed or burned into the spine. Before, when you had dissected the creatures... I'd say maybe you guys never even really thought to flip it over and check out the back, just checked it on the front, cut it open, looked at its organs and stuff. I mean, think about it. Why would you? So you can see that there are inscriptions carved into the spine, and there's a huge scar, like a fucking inch and a half thick scar that runs all the way from the where the spine connects to the skull on the back of your head all the way down to, his tailbone. There's just a huge scar that runs all the way down, and you can see that there is inscriptions, at least on this this top part of it. And they look familiar. So it looks like a series of symbols rather than, language. It might be language, but if it is, it's not one you understand.
It just looks familiar.
Yeah, it looks familiar. It reminds you of something that you'd seen on the skeletons.
Oh, shit.
God damn it, Bone Crag.
Okay, and now you guys have broken into the cabin. As Daigle is there, shouting at you guys and then talking to Lokar, the door flies open of the cabin. And looking inside of it, you can see that it's all, it's like mud. Not mud. It's like hard pack. It's like daub and wattle. There's, shelves inside of here. You can see that there are glass contraptions and vials. There are dried leaves for some reason on the floor. There is, bags with plants inside of them. There is a big wash basin full of water. and there's no torches on in here, but from the torchlight outside, you can see this room, like, you don't see anybody in it right now.
So the kid is gone.
From what you can see, yeah.
As far as we know.
I want to look and see if there's any sign of where he went. Because I'm the first one in, right?
Yes, absolutely. Use a wisdom check.
And then wisdom is plus two.
Okay, there's no sign of where he's went. Looking around inside of the house.
Can I try to track him down with a perception check?
Sure. As you're walking away, Lokar's like, come on, let me out of here.
Fuck you, Lokar. We have bigger and better fish to fry. Yeah, you're free. Congratulations. That's why we're here.
I'm not free.
Yeah, you're not. No one's ever fucking free. Not from this society. Not from this theocracy.
Well, I guess since he walked past me, I'd be trying to get rope from... Because I guess fucking Wilton's just hanging by the door since he just pushed past him.
You and Wilton both burst in the house. Daigle's coming up behind you right now.
Okay.
Can I do a perception check to see if I can see which direction this guy went? So I do have
Yeah, what do you want to do, Wilton? Because you burst in there first, actually, so...
Oh, I'm first? I thought
yeah, I mean, John was first. You and John both burst in there. You're the one who broke it with your crowbar, so like you and John both burst through the door at the same time. John searched the area, what I described you saw.
Alrighty. I don't know. Can I look around too? Can I search around? Do I have a better or do we just see the same shit?
Oh, roll.
Let's find out.
Let's find out. Go learn today.
Right, 18.
All right.
Okay. near a table in the back, you can see like some scrape marks on the floor, and you can see that the table appears to have been pushed back, and you see the outline of a trap door on the ground.
I open it.
Okay. Yeah. You pop the door open, and there's a ladder leading down into the earth.
Ooh, let's go down it.
Fuck that. Seal it. Let's get going. Drop a fucking firebomb in there and let's go.
I can actually, if you light this, I don't have a fucking. Well, I guess I could just drop the arrow down there. If you just light this arrow, I can just throw it in this hole and we can just burn this place to the ground.
I'll spark it with a flint.
John, we made a promise. We made a promise to a dying mom.
We got Lokar. We're getting the fuck out of here. That's the only promise I made.
I was obviously going to kill that kid as soon as we saw him.
Let's get Lokar out of the fucking hole and we're good to go.
I'm a man of science, and I'm sure Edgar is as well. And I feel like we should follow this.
Sorry, but weren't you the one who was trying to leave Lokar just before this?
But before I knew, there's money involved. Okay, Lokar's free.
What fucking money's involved? The only thing we face is a fucking pig person. I got my fucking leftover Desmodivines. Let's get the fuck out of here.
I walk through, ignoring them, and walk down it. I just walk down it with my torch.
Into the hole?
Yeah, into the hole.
Okay,
I follow behind Edgar.
Before Wilton goes down, I grab ropes off of him.
Wait, okay, so...
I just try to snatch ropes off of Wilton before he goes down.
Okay, so did you start going down before Edgar came into the room?
No, because everybody was talking, so we just...
Okay, everybody's arguing, Edgar goes in through the door holding his torch, and he notices the trap door that's been pulled open. It's now obvious, so he walks right past you guys, and he starts climbing down the hole.
Yeah, just without saying nothing.
I follow behind... John takes some rope from me.
Daigle walks outside and he pulls up the... You try to get him loose. He's 15 feet deep down in the hole. What do you want to do?
There's a rope that's connected to his descendants, right? Correct?
Yeah, to the other hole, yeah.
So I pull him up slowly. And then I actually want to question first because I'm afraid he might be a pig man.
Yeah, there's a rope of descendants.
Lokar, you feel a little funny there. Like, you shouldn't go with the side of, like, some eggs, maybe some toast or something for breakfast. You're not feeling, like, very ham-like, are you?
He says, no. I feel like I got my ass kicked, man.
How you feeling? Are you feeling disoriented? Not from just getting knocked outside the head. You feel all right? You feel like you're normal? You feel like you're back to hunting crocs and whatnot?
No. He's like, dude, I just got beat up by some old guy and thrown in a hole next to
any marks on you?
Snarling all God. Weird.
Walk up on Lokar. I grab him by the chin. I turn his neck sideways. I turn it the other way, and I just kind of observe his body looking for scars.
He's like, what are you doing, man? There's no scars on him. There's no cuts or anything like that. It looks like there's a dart mark in his neck, though. It looks like he was shot with a dart, and he's got some bruising.
I see the dart mark. I turn his face back to me and says, I'm just looking for scars. I'm looking to see if you're okay, buddy.
I grab him by the shirt, try to hold him pretty, like, hoistly. Like, I try to cut him free and put him over.
He's not tied up. He's not tied up at all. He's just sitting in the bottom of a hole that's too flat for him to crawl out of.
After I searched him, I turned to Daigle and I tap him on the shoulder. I whisper in his ear, he's clean. And I walk away.
I cut him free. Lokar, you'd be fine making your way back, right? We're about to dive a lot deeper in some shit that, you know, was with. I would like to say it's over your head, but, you know, you've been sitting in a hole, possibly a little bit over your head.
I think we should probably make our way back too. I mean, we fulfilled our contract and then we saved the person we said that we would save and keep safe. We shouldn't be fucking out here. We can always come back, okay? I faced one pigment. I don't want to face another, okay? I can't do it.
Lokar, you'll forgive my lady over here. She whines a lot. Here's the knife. Try to go back safe. try to make it back safe. I know you're a hunter, you're a gatherer, whatever you are. You're the most sort of survivor of that village, I bet. Because I have nothing off you.
He's like, he's looking back and forth at both of you guys, obviously very confused.
Lokar.
I guess I would agree with Daigle and tell Lokar, get to fucking safety, go back to your alligator stand. If we come back, we'll take you to Miser's Peak.
Lokar says, man, I'm not going anywhere alone. He's like, I didn't even want to be in this part of the swamp. I just came here because you guys wanted me to help you.
I didn't want you to be like, here.
And I can't help anymore. Now I need to be helped. So I'm just going
to
stay right here.
I didn't want you to be here, but the part, something that you swear to when you join the Miser's College is you don't leave your brothers behind. You protect them. And all those dumb fucks are going down that stupid fucking hole. So I guess I have to go with him.
He's like, man.
So I say to you.
That's some really righteous
stuff,
man.
I hope you join Miser's College, but I feel like you can get back on your own. I mean, I already killed their god, so
it should be
a pretty easy trek.
Okay, go ahead and do a persuasion or a charisma roll if you're going to try to convince him to head home alone. Okay, yeah, and Lokar said basically, yeah, so Lokar said to you, he's basically like, he's like, man, like I don't feel safe going back. I can't bring myself back now, dude. I need you guys' help. I'm not going anywhere.
I mean, okay, I guess since I was the one who's trying to convince him, I mean, you can fucking follow us, but I wouldn't suggest it.
He's like,
I'm trying to keep these motherfuckers out of trouble. I'm sorry, Nate.
He goes, he says, he's like, shit, man. I guess I'll go back in the hole. And he just crawls, he gets on the rope and he just lowers himself back down into the hole.
Okay, yell at him.
He says, just leave the rope down so I can get out if I need to. I'm safer down here.
Can I yell at him?
I guess if that's how you feel, maybe you weren't ready for Miser's College.
I was no car cook, man.
I hope you find your strength and you make it back to the camp.
Lokar, we made a fucking promise. We dragged you here. We're going to drag your ass back. And that's a promise. I don't know when. We didn't really put a time limit on this. So you might just fucking sit in the hole for a minute, but I mean, you're welcome to finger us down this fucking hole. Down this rabbit hole, but if you turn to a pigman, I fucking swear we'll get you.
Do a persuasion. Yeah. So he says,
He says, I know you guys will come back for me. You guys already came and found me after I got taken away. He's like, I'm just going to be right here, man. Just please come back for me.
I'm guessing I'm not there anymore, so that's Daigle.
Okay, and we go back into the house.
And, wow, Daigle, you piece of shit.
Edgar down at the bottom of the hole. You can see Wilton climbing down the hole. Edgar's at the bottom of the hole. You can see torchlight coming up from down from the entrance of the trapdoor. Edgar down there, you can see that there is a very short tunnel. It looks like a crawlway. It's only about like 3.5 or 4 feet tall. And it's like narrow on the side. So you'd have to crawl down through it. And it just heads down and out somewhere.
I go ahead and crawl through it.
Okay.
Wait, can I turn to Wilton? I just want to turn to Wilton and just kind of like at a medium tone, like talk. It's like, hey, Wilton, you coming? Because I can hear like, I don't know, he was coming down behind me, right? Just making sure he's following behind. I don't want to get in a fight by myself. I'm not equipped for much. Okay. But yeah, and I go down the tunnel.
You see, Edgar. You see Edgar with the torch crawling through the hole, and he calls back for you? He calls back for Wilton? Follow?
Yeah, I just call back for Wilton, and I say, are you coming? Because that's the only person I know that's coming behind me, because he was the last person.
Sure, yeah. Sure.
Does, awesome. What the fuck's your name? John coming down right now as well?
I followed behind watching after you guys like went down.
I just don't know how far in the house he
after
is.
After I was trying to convince Lokar to take off on his own, go back to camp, I noticed that you guys had disappeared, so I again disappeared down the hole.
Okay, that's what I needed to know, because that was going to determine whether I was just
I wasn't going to let y'all go down there by yourselves.
At the bottom of this trapdoor, there's only space for one human being to stand. So it's like all single file down here. So if Edgar's in the hole and Wilton's standing there and hasn't crawled through yet, then there's no room for John to get in yet.
Okay, that's fine. Well, I just need to, because I have a spiderweb torch that I haven't lit yet. So I was just going to see if I can spark that bitch up real quick before. So I can give it to Edgar if he's going down that hole first. He doesn't have a light, I don't think.
He's already got it.
I already got a torch.
Oh, never mind. Fuck it. I would just follow behind him then. Sorry.
Okay, sweet. And then John comes down after you. And Edgar, go ahead and roll an investigation.
Yeah, sorry. I thought you said there was this torchlight coming from above us in the hole, so that's why.
Plus 4.
Okay, 9. All right, so you stick your hand, it presses down on something as you're like crawling on the floor, and a bunch of dirt just caves in over top of you.
Oh shit.
You take 3 points of damage, and you are now suffocating under the collapsed dirt in this tunnel.
Can I pull my shovel out and start digging that motherfucker out?
Yes.
Okay, I start doing that.
Oh, yeah. Good thing the digger's behind you.
Good thing the digger's here. Yeah, so Edgar, you have five turns to get him out. Okay. Go ahead and start roll. Oh, yeah, you use dexterity checks instead of strength checks because you're the most dexterous digger this side of the artery. And go ahead and roll a d20.
Fuck.
Okay, roll another one.
With the +3, so let's, 17.
Okay, yes. That's one success. Go again.
Yes.
Okay, that's 20. Okay, and then just you have to get 2 more successes. So go ahead and roll 2 more. You managed to unbury it. Okay. Yeah, you managed to unbury Edgar. You drag him out by his ankles, and you can see that he is blue in the face, and he like heaves in a huge breath. He's like at the verge of death when you pull him out from the dirt.
I got you, man. I got you. I give him a kiss on the forehead.
And
just don't kiss my mouth.
I give him a French kiss.
And roll an insanity check with advantage for being buried alive.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God.
And almost dying.
Nice.
Okay, nice.
I mean, I'm okay. Free.
Yeah, you're okay. Tight. Yeah. So, yeah, you get out there. I mean, like, just you could tell you were on your last few seconds of air. You were about to die. You arrive at the bottom of the hole, John. It's gone completely dark because the torch has been buried inside of the tunnel, and you can't see anything, but you can hear Edgar gasping for breath somewhere deeper in the tunnel, and you heard the big shifting of dirt.
The first thing I'm going to do is just kind of reach forward for an ankle or something.
You find, you find Wilton's ankle.
Okay. And then I give like a tug and I'm like, is everything okay?
John, grab the torch out of my bag and light that bitch.
Okay. So I grab the torch and I light it with my flint.
All right, sweet. Yeah, you get it lit, and now you're looking. You can see that Edgar's laying on his back on, like, a pile of dirt, and Wilton's, like, right in front of him, and he's got his shovel out, and there's been a huge cave-in, and the tunnel is gone now.
Behind us?
No.
Well, forward. Edgar, let's get the fuck out of here while you still can.
So I get, it's just like, we got fucking nowhere to go. Let's just fucking turn back and leave this place.
Can I shuffle Edgar in front of, like, my line?
Shuffle, like, can I make what?
Like, okay, so, like, because the order is right now, because it's Edgar, me, and then John's kind of on the ladder, I guess. I don't know, because there's not really room for anybody to be down here.
Yeah, you guys are both in the tunnel, so he's standing behind you guys now.
Okay. Okay.
You see what I mean? Yeah, there's like a...
I was going to say backwards, because obviously Edgar's fucking wounded and out of breath and shit. So I was going to say, couldn't I switch positions with him? But if we're still in that little ass tunnel, we can't, so...
Yeah.
Is there no way to shimmy underneath them to get back to the start? Or do we have to push forward?
We can back out. Yeah, we just can't go forward. We can back out.
Okay, so you guys can't go forward in the tunnel without me? It's like completely...
The tunnel's collapsed.
I have the torch now. I look at those two and I say, I told you we should fucking leave. Let's just get the fuck out of here. I need to grab at least one more Desmodifier and we're fucking good to go.
Okay, so John crawls, climbs back up the ladder, and you guys go in like a reverse ascending order, and you guys get out of the hole, and you guys are standing back in the cabin now.
What the fuck is Daigle doing up there since he didn't follow
his
power?
He's telling stories. You hear him talk. Daigle, you go ahead. You hear him telling stories to Lokar.
That is so fucking
Daigle.
The
whole fucking place burned down. We fucking go on this road. We met some fucking homeless man. Oh, here's a little piece of bread. Here's a little piece of wine. You seem like a good fella down in your luck. You fucking tries to kill us. It's fucking crazy.
I slap him on the shoulder. Go, Jesus fucking Christ! Do you ever shut up? You scared him back into the damn hole. Lokar, get the fuck up here.
Lokar looks up and he says. He says, you know, I actually feel a lot better, man. It's been nice having somebody talk to me for a while.
Yeah, no one wants to hear this motherfucker. He's always talking.
Guess what, John? That's no way to talk to a plus member of the Sloppy Sister.
A plus member of the Sloppy Sister? What the fuck is this?
Lokar crawls up to the top, and like he just climbs up the rope that was sitting in his hole, and he just stands up at the top, and he says, he's like, you just call me a sloppy sister?
You get us out of this swamp, we get back to Miser's, we'll call you one of the sloppy sister.
Sorry, I got a little bit tipsy while you guys were away. There was a wine cabinet in that lodging, and I fucking fed myself to it, so it was pretty nice.
Anyways, we're going I'm proposing to go back the way we came, and then on the way back, I'm going to grab some Desmodivines.
Am I too injured to investigate that the inside of that place? God damn.
Yeah, it's been checked thoroughly.
Same level. Oh, you said, but you guys also, all you guys seen were plants and everything else. Yep. But what I can see might be herbs and everything else. I have nature and mineral knowledge. That's why I want to make sure there's nothing that's not, yeah.
Oh, wait, that's actually, yeah, go ahead. Okay, I shouldn't say there's no Dismodivines right away. Sorry.
Okay, well, I want to check for those. And then, Edgar is checking before me because
Edgar, covered in dust and blood, dirt and blood. Starts checking the inventory of the household. Go ahead and do an investigation check.
As Wilton's dragging me out, I'm like, wait, and I start looking around. Damn.
plus your investigation.
Plus 1, 10.
You find a few dried bits of rattlestock.
I don't know what that is.
So,
Nate, good job with coming up with all the ingredients, dude. Because you've named off so many, I don't know.
He's got that in my book. You said dry, like, or a few.
Yeah, there's like, three of them. Three uses of it. Rattlestocks times three for your inventory.
Rattlestock sounds like poison.
Can I put my head on or my hand on Edgar's shoulder and tell him something? Edgar, you're a fine man. You're a man of science, aren't you? Discovering, you know, you're on the cusp of explorations. Whatever the fuck is in these vines is what's attracting the pigman. That's what they eat. That's what they devour. And that's what they're set with. Next time we come in contact with them, we slit their throats so they cannot consume any more because it makes him immortal.
He didn't find his Dismodivines.
But I'm just telling him in general. So, be on the lookout. Discover. Look up. If you could find any books, anything on these vines, this stuff is demonic and it's fucking powerful. And that will lead us to a new cause.
I mean, I'm looking for Dismodivines, so you want me to roll a d20?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I have plus 4 survival.
Okay, well, that's not going to be survival inside the house. It's just going to be like a perception check. But yeah, you look around and you don't seem to find any Dismata. Lokar's like, yeah, come on, man. Let's get out of here. He's like, dude, you guys take me back right now. He's like, you know, I'll round up a couple more turtles, man. We'll get back to this soup.
is he like not able to walk or is he fine?
That sounds devoid.
Yeah, Lokar. How fucked up is he?
Okay. He's okay. He was fine enough to crawl up a rope. So
okay. Well, anyways, I'm like, let's just get the fuck out of here. And I point towards the broken hole in the fence. He's like, we don't even have to fucking climb.
Can I tell Lokar like, we'll be fine. A couple of soups of turtles sounds so good. That sounds good, does it, Lokar? You know, not notice one of mine. That doesn't sound good, does it? Does it fucking sound good? I put my knife. If it fucking sounds good, don't worry. I'm fucking in it right here. I'm watching you, pig boy.
I put my hand on Dagon and be like, fucking relax, dude.
Say, why does he keep calling me a pig man, dude? Like,
I ain't no pig man. Trust me, I fucking know. But
I'm a sloppy sister. I'm a pig man. What happened to you guys?
What a good fun. I have to get the fuck out of here before
more pig men come. This is not our place. We need to fucking go.
As you guys are leaving through that broken part of the fence and he sees the giant beheaded pig man laying there, he goes, oh, what the fuck is that, man?
That's the fucking enemy.
That right there is something you don't find in the swamp.
He says, that's fucking reality. Fucking enemies. Your enemies look like.
I'm completely.
You see the damage on my fucking face. You see all the shit that's happened to me. That's what that did. I barely fucking made it out of this alive. So don't judge these enemies. We just need to fucking leave. You can learn more at Miser's College.
He said, I'm not going to Miser's College, man. I'm just going back to the village.
And we'll get you there, Loke.
Obviously, these pig people are in this area, and the only people I've ever known to fucking beat these pig people is Miser's College. So if you just want to sit here and wait for something to happen, go ahead and stay here all you want. You can go ahead and cook your fucking alligator all you fucking like. But we're heading home, and we're going to a place we can protect. You can come with us or not, but just know.
Persuade with advantage. Okay, so he doesn't say anything, but he looks at you and he just kind of stares and he nods a little bit, and you can see that as you guys are like starting to walk back in the moonlight towards the to the west towards your guys' old camp to go swoop up more Desmodivine. You can tell he's thinking about it as you guys are walking.
Can I just look at him? I look at him and respond to what he said. I look at him, I smile and I wink, and I say, no, that's not the enemy. That's just their cattle.
That's just their cattle. Lokarn, you are walking around the back. As you guys start heading through the jungle back west towards that trail in the ruins, near the ruins, you guys hear a loud bugle horn blow. Somewhere in the deep forest, maybe it's the sound of a creature, like an elk or something like that, or maybe it's somebody blowing into a horn. It's kind of hard.
Can I grab him, jump into the bushes, quickly use my self. I have a 3+ on self. I grab him, pull him into the bushes, we jump in the bushes.
Just to let you know, this horn sounds like it's very far away.
Can I send my bird up? Can it spot which way it's coming from, or could we tell which way?
Lokar says, he says, man, we should get the hell out of here. He says, that's a Gazanso horn.
What's a Gazanso?
He's like, dude, that's the other tribe that used to live out in these swamps, man. Apparently they're still here. He says, I thought that old guy who caught me looked a little,
different. Lokar, they wouldn't happen to be the ones that were following Zimbakto, were they?
He says, yeah, that's the ones. They're the ones that believe. This embodies the embodiment of their revenge.
I look to the rest and say, fucking book it, because I want to double pace, and I want to try to get the rest of them to double pace too. Try to get the fuck out of here.
Before we dip, can I ask Lokar, what does Zimbakta look like?
You can ask you're dipping even.
We murdered Zimbakta.
He says,
I just want to dip out because I don't even have my weapon, my main.
You guys can talk as you're moving. It's fine.
Okay.
So as you're hurriedly heading back towards there, you ask him what Zimbakta looks like or whatever.
What is the physical embodiment of Zimbakta?
He says nobody's ever. It's a really old legend. He says, but there's nothing that really says about what he looks like. They've just been calling that thing that you guys killed. I saw you guys carrying its head. That gray creature that's been stalking the woods and
killing. I look towards him and go, the dumb gray bitch.
He says, yeah, the dumb gray bitch. He says, yeah, that's what people have been referring to as Zimbakta, like, lately.
Well, I don't think he's any kind of god because my buddies here killed him pretty goddamn easily. I didn't even get a chance to fight.
Well, he's not a god. Nobody worships him. They just think that he's more of a servant than a god.
It seems like they fucking worship him.
They care for him.
They think of him more like a protector than anything.
Yeah, that's it. He's like a protector.
Gods and guardians are separate creatures all alone.
He says, the protector of their tribe would have to be weak because, you know, they lost the swamp to us, so.
Wait a minute.
Well, if they're planning on doing anything feisty, let's get back to your clan and see if they want to fight with us.
He says, dude, I didn't even know there were any of them out here before, but we have some of their old horns that are hundreds, maybe even thousands of years old. So I've heard what they sound like. That sounded just like one coming from the south.
Could this be your clan?
Speak back.
He says, it's definitely not my clan. We don't go to the southern swamps. This place is cursed, man. I told you guys. So you guys are back to the camp now. The original camp that you guys had. You can see the burnt out fire and everything. There's some stones and there's still a few Desmodivines poking out. Do you want to do anything while you're here?
I'm gonna grab some Desmodivines, and then I'm gonna look back to them and say, "Who has the fucking head?" As I'm grabbing the Desmodivines.
Okay. Yeah. You cut another good length of Desmodivine. Are you cutting one or two lengths? How many?
I'll fucking cut two since I lost three.
John.
I have one mulch. Good enough.
John, this attracts the fucking pigmen if you haven't fucking told by now.
Yeah, but I've been sitting on... I've been chosen to do something.
Yeah, you have. You're crazy. You're going to attract the crazier. It's on you.
I got two lengths.
Okay. Yeah, so you cut two lengths of the Desmodivine. They leak black goo and they begin writhing and pulling back into the rocks, the remaining lengths of them. And yeah, you wrap them up in your cloth, and Lokar's like, man, he's like, really, you're gonna take more of that shit? That shit's evil, dude. And he's like, let's go, let's get out of here.
Can I?
You don't think I know it's evil? I was chosen to grab this shit. I don't care if it's evil or good. It's mine now.
I elbow Edgar in the shoulder, and I go, hey, is it me? Or is fucking John a pig man? Secretly, he's a fucking pig man, isn't he?
He is starting to act aggressively like one.
How are you guys being real whispery, like trying to hide it?
Yeah. I'm being okay. Super secret. I'm
so do a stealth roll. Do a stealth roll to.
My voice is really weak. I assume my voice is really weak. So
I have a plus three on stealth.
Okay, so do a wisdom check versus them, John. See if you can hear. Yeah, John hears you.
I walk over calmly because I don't want to startle them. And I grab Dago by the shoulder and I go, you think I'm a fucking pig man? I may have
squealed in his ear.
I have a lot in common with those fucks.
But I'm not going to challenge you, John.
I am not a fucking pig man. The pig men have perverted what I am.
John, you're very strong, man. You think you're the only one that...
You think you're the only one that suffered?
Shh. Edgar?
I have no doubt that you guys suffered, but your guys' people have not been perverted by these dumbass pigmen.
Yeah, not before, but our people all didn't come from royal blood.
You think royal fucking blood matters at Miser's Mercenary College? Why do you think I like Miser so much? I get to get away from all that bullshit.
Well, it doesn't seem like you're getting rid of your past by bitching about your background at the Miser's College. Now does it? We're supposed to work it as a team, and you're the one being aggressive here. You're the one that is storming off. You're the one that is going berserk. You're the one that is only separated by these war people.
I'm not aggressive because of my upbringing. I'm aggressive because they've perverted everything that I am.
No, but
everything that the Miser's College has built me up towards. They perverted it. They turned it into something dark. This is not what scarification is supposed to be.
And what is it supposed to be? I turn to Daigle. I'm like, this isn't going to end well for anybody. And then I get that same look I had back at the tournament.
I'm quiet. And then I go over to the Wilton.
The blood. Oh,
no.
Bullcrack. We're a family here, but I'm fucking scared. I don't know if I'm gonna stick my eyes open, honestly.
Oh, As you're saying that, you see that a pink light begins in the sky as the sun begins to rise for the next day.
I grab a shot of brandy after the stress that I just been to and feeling stress that I just went through this with my brothers. I don't have brandy, I have rum. I grab a swig of rum. I eat my ration in the morning, looking at them still somewhat feeling slighted as if they don't trust me, but I'm trying to numb myself with the alcohol. And I'm just staying close to Lokar, trying to keep him safe.
Okay, the rum reminds you of Hobarks. It's the same that he used to drink.
Naturally, and I think to myself, like, what the fuck have I become? I mean, Wilton, everyone has been burnt by these Desmodifines. Why is it not hurting me? What the fuck else is wrong with my body? I came out of this fucking college covered in scars, but knowing I was stronger, but what exactly has it done to my body?
Are you guys continuing to head back to the,
Yeah.
Okay, so let's do a quick... Okay, sweet. So after a few hours of trudging through the swamps again, you guys get to move at a bit of a faster pace, having Lokar show you through like the dangerous areas of the swamp and how to circumnavigate like sink pits and whatnot. You eventually come to the outskirts of the village again, and you can see in the morning time that there are like a bunch of children out on the floating island. You can see that there are a couple of fires burning, and there are people holding torches, and there are several men standing towards the outside of the village that are like holding spears. You can see the chief in the center of the village, and he seems to be doing some sort of a smoke ritual. And as you guys arrive, the ceremony stops, and they all look towards your group. And Lokar just jumps right across the ravine of the water and just runs to the other side and just starts, like, kissing the ground. He's just, like, so happy to be back.
Who has the head? Do I have the head?
I think I do, don't I? I have the head, I guess.
I grab it.
They see Wilton pass that. So you guys are standing at the edge of the trench that surrounds the village and has the water in it. Like, it's like a little river around the village. You guys are standing at the edge of that. They see you pass the head between each other, and all the children just scatter. They go running. Some of them jump into the water and dive down, and other ones just run towards the back of the village, the back of the island, or like behind the village elder. And it's a chief. It's a guy. And you hear the chief go, "Zembakta is fallen." And the townspeople begin to cheer. He says to the man next to him, he says, "Please retrieve the chest." And you see a man, he drops his spear on the ground next to the elder, and he dives down into the water. And the chief says to another one, he says, "Hey, bring the others." And another guy goes and dives down into the water. And you can see that there is like a grate in the center of this floating island. And there's like smoke coming up from it. And you can see around the edges of the water start brimming with people. And like dozens of people are just like swimming up from underwater and climbing up to the edges of the village. And two of them are holding a big chest that they bring out. And they open the chest in front of you, and it has your guy's reward. And he looks over to you, Daigle. He looks first at John, and he's like, "Thank you for bringing us the creature's head. You will haunt our swamp no longer."
Can I say something, Daigle?
Hey, so Jordan might have brought your creature.
He's in the middle of a speech. Head,
but I fucking brought its soul. Well, I fucking killed that. I'm the one that fucking put the knife in the chest. I'm the one that stabbed the beast to death. And I'm the one that that heard its last words. Saying, "Oh, never bother no mankind again." And I've heard that with my own ears. So to me, my skull is worth a lot more than that one. And it's here for you.
So he says to Daigle, he says, "And you promised you would bring it to us within one day. And you've done this. So this is your reward." And they open the chest. There's a package that's wrapped in there, and he picks it up with both hands, and he hands it over to you, and he says, "This is for Nisbi and those at Miser's Keep." He says, "This was to be given to you to deliver to them. And for you, in the bottom of the chest, there's just a ton of gold pieces." And so when you look in there, there's just a pile of gold in the bottom, and there's 8 pieces for each of you.
Hell yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah. You have the head in your hands. He was handing it to Daigle. His hands are free.
Okay. I looked at Daigle and said, "You best hand that to me."
"Well, I best not. It looks like you got your hands full with some garbage."
"So I'll fucking trade you then."
No, yeah, it doesn't look like it'd fit me right. Sir, may I ask what's in the package? I know it's none of my business, but I'm just curious since I'm going to be the delivery boy.
He says, "Nothing dangerous. It is merely payment."
"Payment? By how much gold?"
He says, "I don't know, man. Like, I guess he would just tell you." Like, he's like, "There's a..." He says, "Well, there's a pretty sum..." It cost us a pretty sum of gold to bring you here.
"Yeah, that honors me that you'd have me hold on to it, but I'm a man of my word. Otherwise, I wouldn't be who I am."
Word. Yeah, so the head falls at the feet of the elder, and he looks you in the eyes, and he nods solemnly. And he goes back to doing his smoke throughout the village, and they begin singing kind of a wailing song, like a wail. And they start like they start roasting, and you can see that there's like way more people than you thought were in this village before, and more are still coming up from underneath in the water, and there's like about like 60 or 70 people like in the village now that are like standing on this island, and they seem to just be like setting up for a feast as you guys are walking away.
Can I'd like to tell the elder
Don't forget to call again. We're always here. And then I just fucking, I walk away. That's, I just say it really fucking fast before I'm leaving.
Okay. Yeah. He nods Edgar? To you as you say. Oh yeah.
My shit cut off. I was just going to point to the people having a feast. It's like, I'd love to stick around with this. And I look at the elder. It's like, do you have anywhere possibly that I can rest for a while? I've taken the most damage here. So yeah.
He says, of course. All of you are welcome to rest in the chief shack. He says, just climb the largest of the elms towards the back of the village. He says, go up there, you may rest.
I'm just sitting underneath a tree drinking my brandy, already chilling.
Yeah. You see Wilton passing out underneath one of the trees just right away. He's so tired.
And I go to Daigle and be like, what exactly did you just grab?
I want to know exactly what he just got.
Well, we're not supposed to open business. It, are we?
It's business. It's not your fucking business until we answer business, all right? So go beyond. Do your thing. You got paid, didn't you? Don't wander further than that.
And I go over to Lokar and I go, I think you've earned your way back. If you want to come with us, I suggest you do. Just remember, this swamp might fall in the next day or two, judging by what's happening.
So I meet him at Lokar as well. And okay,
as you come up, Lokar is saying to John, he says,
I've been thinking about it, and he says, and I think if we're gonna get out of here, and we're gonna head to this place where there's all these warriors and shit, maybe that's where I should go. He's like, I've never really felt, you know, too close to the tribe here. Been a bit of an oddball to them, you know, just been roasting alligators, you know, trying to have a good time. And doesn't seem like it's safe here anymore for me, bros.
You really feel like you have no future here. You should really try Miser's College.
He says, of course. Well, he says, if you guys are going to go rest, I'll go ahead and I'll warn them about these pig bros that you guys are talking about, because they probably need to know that.
You should definitely tell them of the dangers that await.
I go up to Lokar, I do hand him 4 pieces of gold. That's for all your hard work, and I appreciate you. I told you I'd split the bounty with you, and there you go.
You do what? You give him 4 gold?
Yeah, of the 8 pieces I made. I told you I'd split the bounty with you, and there
to Lokar?
Lokar.
Yeah, Lokar is like, oh shit. He looks at the 4 gold and he's like, oh shit, I've never had this much in my life.
Me neither. just joking. Where I come from, I, you know.
You had a silver bar that you gave away, you untrustworthy bastard.
You hear Weldon mutter in his sleep.
I'm a man of charity. I'm a man of charity.
Okay, tight, guys. And I'll get you your... Yeah, so with that, you guys rest up in the chief's cabin. You can smell food cooking outside. And you know that this village is like celebrating for themselves, you know? And I'm sure you'll be ready to adventure out in the morning. Possibly with Lokar. Or not in the morning, because it's morning now. But in a couple of hours when you wake up. That's where we'll end it today. So you guys have brought the head back to the chief, and you guys have retrieved the payment for Miser's Peak, as well as like a bunch of gold for yourselves, and you guys have survived. You guys survived another day. Good job.